A thing that has always bothered me for the last 30 years comes from a movie called Star Trek Generations, which came out in 1994, and it was sort of the passing of the torch between the old guard Shatner and the new guard Picard. There's a bad guy in the movie, and his plan is to blow up a star by launching a rocket into the star, and the rocket would then cause energy production at the center of the star to stop. In this climactic scene where Picard and the bad guy are fighting, the bad guy manages to launch the rocket into the heart of the star. Now, this is from an Earth-like planet, so it's going to be an Earth-like distance away from the star, and it takes only about 5 or 6 seconds for the rocket to be launched from the surface of the planet and go all the way into the heart of the star. So that's always been my first real problem with this scene, is that this violates what we call causality, right? It takes about 10 minutes for light to go from the sun to the Earth. So it'd be about the same amount of time for light to go, say, from the planet to this particular star. And clearly, this must mean that the rocket is going much, much faster than the speed of light for this to happen in 5 or 6 seconds. That simply could not happen. But then the next thing that it gets wrong is a little bit more subtle and actually really interesting point about how light is made in stars, is that they watch, and as the rocket goes into the sun and stops energy production in the core of the star immediately becomes very dim. It almost gets completely black instantaneously. And that is not actually what would happen. Even if you could manage to get fusion at the center of a star to stop, you wouldn't notice on the surface of the star, not for a very, very long time, because in fact it takes photons, little bits of light, almost 30,000 years to go from the point that they're created at the core to travel through the atmosphere of the star, bouncing around all the hot, dense gases, before they finally actually reach the surface of the star and are then emitted as light that we would actually see. Then, of course, once this happens, the star blows up and it expands, and we once again have violation of the rule that nothing can go faster than the speed of light, because now the surface of the star expands out and envelops the planet in, you know, even less time than it took the rocket to get there. However, one thing that it does get right, if a star suddenly stops being able to create energy at the core will collapse. And then a little bit later on, the outer part of the star will also collapse. The inner part of the star will actually compress to a very dense knot and bounce back. And so when the core of the star is going out, the outer part of the star comes in, these inner and outer parts slam into each other, and that is what we call a supernova. Usually this only happens with really big, bright blue stars, not with this particular sort of star that you would see in the movie Star Trek. But you know, if you manage to find some artificial way to stop energy production at the core of a star, you could probably actually get this sort of result.